I am Usnavi, but you probably never heard my name. Reports of my fame were greatly exaggerated, exacerbated by the fact that my syntax is highly complicated, cause I immigrated from the single greatest little place in the Caribbean, Dominican Republic. I love it, Jesus, I'm jealous of it, and beyond that, ever since my folks passed on, I haven't gone back. God damn, I gotta get on that. My cousin running just another dime and dozen mom and pop stopping shop, and oh my god, it's gotten too darn hot. Like my man Cole Porter said, people come through for a few cold waters and a lottery ticket, just a part of the routine. Everybody's got a job, everybody's got a dream. They gossip as I sip my coffee and smirk the first stop as people hop to work. Bust it, I'm like $1, $2, $1.50, $1.69. I got it. You want a box of condoms? What kind? That's two quarter waters. The New York Times, you need a bag for that, the tax is added. Once you get some practice at it, you do rapping mathematics automatically, selling maxi pads, fuzzy dice for taxi cabs. Practically everybody's stressed, yes, but they press through the mess, bounce checks and wonder what's next. Bartender, let me get an amaretto sour before this ghetto flower. How are you so pretty? You complete me, you have me a hello, you know you need me, truly, madly, deeply, let's get freaky. Oh, I get it, you the strong and silent type. Well, I'm the Caribbean island type and I can drive you wild all night, but I digress. Say something so I don't stress. Yes. Yo, I know just where to go. There's a little beach named Playa Rincon with no roads. You need a rowboat, a motorbike to reach this beach. It's just a stone's throw from home. My folks is home. Before I was gone, before they passed on and left me on my own in New York with the grocery store. They would talk about home, I listened closely for the way they whispered to each other, but the warmer winter weather, inseparable, they even got sick together. They never got better, passed away that December, and left me with these memories like dying embers from a dream I can't remember. Ever since then, it's like another day, deeper in debt with different dilemmas. The boy, that guy's a mess, I'll be seeing less of Vanessa. Abuela, I don't know how I can keep it together. Seeing she was already lying in bed, the paramedics said that her heart gave out. I mean, it's basically what they said. They said a combination of the stress and the heat. Why she never took her medicine, I'll never understand. I like to think she went out in peace, with pieces of breadcrumbs in her hand. Abuela Claudia had simple pleasures. She sang the praises of things we ignore. Glass Coke bottles, breadcrumbs, a sky full of stars. She cherished these things. She'd say, Alabanza. Alabanza means to raise this thing to God's face and to sing quite literally praise for this. When she was here, the path was clear. She was just here. Just when you think you're sick of living here, the memory floods in. The morning light off the fire escapes. The nights at Bennett Park watching Big Pun tapes. I'ma miss this place, to tell you the truth. Kevin dispensing some wisdom from his dispatch booth in the dawn. Vanessa at the salon. Gotta move on. But who's gonna notice we're gone? When our job's done, as the evening winds down to a cross sun, can I ease my mind when we're all done? When we've resigned in the long run, what do we leave behind? Most of all, I miss Abuela's whispers, doing the lotto pick six every Christmas. In 5 years, when this whole city's rich folks and hipsters, who's gonna miss this raggedy little business?